Γεια σας φίλοι μου! Hello my friends! Welcome! Καλώς ήρθατε! Today you're going to learn how to describe a house from the outside. First we're going to see a house in the countryside and then we're going to see the houses in the city. So this is a vocabulary lesson, you're going to learn a lot of new words and I've also added some adjectives in this one. So let's begin! Τι είναι αυτό? Τι είναι αυτό? Αυτό είναι ένα σπίτι. Αυτό είναι ένα σπίτι. Πού βρίσκεται αυτό το σπίτι? Πού βρίσκεται αυτό το σπίτι? Είναι στην εξοχή. Είναι στην εξοχή. Πόσους ορόφους έχει? Πόσους ορόφους έχει? Έχει δύο ορόφους. Είναι διόροφο. Έχει δύο ορόφους. Είναι διόροφο. Αυτό είναι το ισόγειο. Αυτό είναι το ισόγειο. Αυτός είναι ο πρώτος όροφος. Αυτός είναι ο πρώτος όροφος. Αυτή είναι η στέγη. Or, αυτή είναι η σκεπή. Αυτή είναι η στέγη. Αυτή είναι η σκεπή. Είναι φτιαγμένη από κεραμίδια. Είναι φτιαγμένη από κεραμίδια. Αυτή είναι η καμινάδα του σπιτιού. Αυτή είναι η καμινάδα του σπιτιού. Είναι πέτρινη. Είναι πέτρινη. Αυτό είναι το μπαλκόνι. Αυτό είναι το μπαλκόνι. Είναι γεμάτο λουλούδια. Είναι γεμάτο λουλούδια. Αυτή είναι η μπαλκονόπορτα. Αυτή είναι η μπαλκονόπορτα. Αυτή είναι η εξώπορτα. Αυτή είναι η εξώπορτα. Η εξώπορτα είναι ξύλινη. Η εξώπορτα είναι ξύλινη. Το παράθυρο είναι ανοιχτό. Το παράθυρο είναι ανοιχτό. Τα παντζούρια είναι ανοιχτά. Τα παντζούρια είναι ανοιχτά. Είναι μια γλάστρα στο περβάζι. Είναι μια γλάστρα στο περβάζι. Υπάρχουν και μερικοί θάμνοι στην αυλή. Υπάρχουν και μερικοί θάμνοι στην αυλή. Και αυτό τι είναι? Και αυτό τι είναι? Είναι ένας λευκός ξύλινος φράχτης. Είναι ένας λευκός ξύλινος φράχτης. Τώρα είμαστε στην πόλη. Τώρα είμαστε στην πόλη. Είναι νύχτα. Είναι νύχτα. Αυτά τα μεγάλα κτίρια είναι πολυκατοικίες. Αυτά τα μεγάλα κτίρια είναι πολυκατοικίες. Έχουν πολλούς ορόφους. Είναι πολυόροφα κτίρια. Έχουν πολλούς ορόφους. Είναι πολυόροφα κτίρια. Τα παράθυρα είναι φωτισμένα. Τα παράθυρα είναι φωτισμένα. Όλα τα φώτα είναι αναμένα. Όλα τα φώτα είναι αναμένα. Κοίτα εκεί ψηλά στην ταράτσα. Κοίτα εκεί ψηλά στην ταράτσα. Κάποιος έχει απλώσει τα ρούχα. Κάποιος έχει απλώσει τα ρούχα. Now let's see the vocabulary. We will see the words separately in groups according to what part of speech they are. If you are beginners, don't be overwhelmed by the different endings of the words. We haven't talked about the declension of the adjectives or the nouns or the participles yet, but this is a good start to get familiarized with the grammar. So, let's begin. First, we're going to see the countryside house and all of its vocabulary. Nouns. Το σπίτι. Το σπίτι. It means house or home. Η εξοχή. Η εξοχή. The countryside, the outdoors. Ο όροφος. Ο όροφος. The floor or the story. Το ισόγειο. Το ισόγειο. The ground floor. It literally means the one that is the same as the ground. The same height as the ground. Η στέγη. Η στέγη. The roof. Or you can say η σκεπή. Η σκεπή. They are both feminine nouns and they mean the same thing. Τα κεραμίδια. Τα κεραμίδια. The roof tiles. This one is in the plural, but you can also find it in the singular number. Η καμινάδα. Η καμινάδα. The chimney. Το μπαλκόνι. Το μπαλκόνι. That's an easy one, the balcony. Τα λουλούδια. Τα λουλούδια. The flowers. It is in the plural. Η μπαλκονόπορτα. Η μπαλκονόπορτα. The balcony door, the door of the balcony. Η εξώπορτα. Η εξώπορτα. The front door. As you can see, both μπαλκονόπορτα and εξώπορτα are compound words, the second being πόρτα, which means, of course, door. Το παράθυρο. Το παράθυρο. The window. Τα παντζούρια. Τα παντζούρια. The shutters. Η γλάστρα. Η γλάστρα. The flower pot. Το περβάζι. Το περβάζι. The windowsill. Η θάμνη. Η θάμνη. The shrubs or the bushes, it is in the plural here, but of course we can find it also in the singular. Η αυλή. Η αυλή. The yard. Ο φράχτης. Ο φράχτης. The fence. Pronouns. Τι. Τι. It is an interrogative pronoun and it means what. And it is the only pronoun in this lesson that isn't declinable. It has only one form. Αυτός, αυτή, αυτό. We have met that many times in our lessons. It is a demonstrative pronoun. It means this. But like most pronouns, it is declinable. It has genders, cases, and numbers. And of course, we're going to see all the pronouns in different lessons. Πόσος, πόσι, πόσο. It means how much in the singular, how many in the plural. Here we have the plural because this is the number we used in our example. Πόσι, πόσες, πόσα. How many. It is an interrogative pronoun, of course, with three genders, numbers and cases. Μερικοί, μερικές, μερικά. An indefinite pronoun that has only the plural number. It means some. Some men, some women, some apples, some things. But of course, there are other pronouns that mean the same thing. We're going to see all that in different lessons. Verbs. Είμαι, to be. Βρίσκομαι, βρίσκομαι, to be located or simply to be. Έχω, έχω, to have, a very important and very common verb. Υπάρχω, υπάρχω, it means to exist, to be, and also it is used in the third person singular and plural, like there is, there are in English. Adjectives and participles. Διόροφος, διόροφη, διόροφο. It means to story. It is a compound word, first δύο, the number δύο, and όροφος, which means floor or story, as we already saw. Πρώτος, πρώτη, πρώτο. It is an ordinal number and it means first. Φτιαγμένος, φτιαγμένη, φτιαγμένο. This is a participle. It is from the verb φτιάχνω, which means to make. And just like adjectives, the participles have three genders, cases and numbers. Πέτρινος, πέτρινη, πέτρινο. It is an adjective and it means made of stone. Γεμάτος, γεμάτη, γεμάτο. An adjective, it means full. Ξύλινος, ξύλινη, ξύλινο. It means wooden, made of wood. Ανοιχτός, ανοιχτή, ανοιχτό. It means open. And finally, λευκός, λευκή, λευκό. It means white, it's a color. And now let's continue with the city. Nouns. Η πόλη. Η πόλη. The city or the town. Η νύχτα. Η νύχτα. The night. Τα κτίρια. Τα κτίρια. The buildings, it is in the plural here. Οι πολυκατοικίες. Πολυκατοικίες. It literally means multi-residence. And here it is in the plural. Τα φώτα. Τα φώτα. The lights, it is in the plural here. Η ταράτσα. Η ταράτσα. The rooftop. Τα ρούχα. Τα ρούχα. The clothes. Pronouns. We only have one pronoun in this part. κάποιος, κάποια, κάποιο. It means someone or somebody. And of course, it has three genders and two numbers and cases. Verbs. Only two new verbs here. We saw the form κοίτα, which is an imperative form of the verb κοιτάζω, or κοιτάω, or κοιτώ. And we also saw έχει απλώσει, which means has hung out to dry. And it is a past tense called παρακείμενος. We're going to see more about that in later lessons. And as you can see, it is formed with the help of the verb έχω, to have. And the verb is απλώνω, which means a lot of things, stretch, lay, extend, etc. Adjectives and participles. Μεγάλος, μεγάλη, μεγάλο. It means big or large, a very common adjective. Πολύς, πολύ, πολύ. This is also a very useful and common adjective, but it is a bit hard to decline. We're going to see that in a separate lesson, of course. It means a lot, much, and in the plural it also means many. Πολυόροφος, πολυόροφη, πολυόροφο. It means multi-story. It is a compound word, just like the όροφος that we saw earlier. Πολύ, multi, a lot, many. Όροφος, story or floor. And two participles for the end. Φωτισμένος, φωτισμένη, φωτισμένο. It means lit, lit up. Αναμένος, αναμένη, αναμένο. It means lit up for a fire or turned on for the lights or other appliances. Adverbs. And finally, we have two adverbs here. Τώρα, which means now, and ψηλά, which means highly, high up. So that was it, my friends. I know this might be a bit overwhelming, a lot of adjectives, a lot of words that need to be declined, but we haven't learned about all that yet. It is just an overview, and in time you're going to learn everything. So, it's very hot here in Greece these days, it's almost impossible to stay inside without air conditioning, of course. I would love to know what's going on in your countries. Is it hot? Is it cold? What's the weather like? If you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give it a thumbs up. See you next time! Bye bye!